What's going on, guys? It's BLAZEDRAKE, as you can call me Hagen, and in today's video, we're going to be going over the complete ultimate guide to the map 9. Now, this isn't a scripted video because I thought it would be best if I just showed you guys how to go about the map. So this is how you spawn in. You go straight through this door, and you're going to be right here into this Coliseum. Just amazing, just graphically pleasing, just amazing Coliseum. I'm a big, huge fan of mythology, so you guys can imagine how I really like this just area in general. But with that out of the way, we're gonna get straight into this guide. So this is the challenge podium. You guys can also look on the top left of your screen. It'll tell you where you are, so it'll be a lot easier to understand this guide. This is where you will be doing all of your challenges, receiving all your rewards, and this is also where you will get a part. So anyway, like I said, you spawn in from right here. First thing you're gonna see on your right is a door that you can actually go through. And this will be the door that we go through, but after that is this actual banner. Now, these banners are all across the map, or at least in this Coliseum, as you guys can see. And these are actual challenges that you guys can do to receive items. So what you're going to do is you're going to come up to these cords, and you're just going to cut them with your knife. And you're going to get these challenges on the left part of your screen. Mine is get 6 equipment kills, but we're not going to do that right now, because we want to get through the entire map. But the challenge is going to correspond to different, like goblets of fire, if you will, Harry Potter reference. And you just do them, you come here to receive your reward, and you receive another challenge. You guys can look at another video that I have that will show all the rewards for these challenges. But anyway, like I said, you're gonna see another challenge and then another door you can go through. These are doors that you will eventually go through to come out of, I believe. These are like boss zombie ones, but these are the ones you're gonna be coming out of later on in the map. But anyway, let's just go through this first door that you come in on your right. You come through here, you're gonna open up the door. I'm actually in custom mutation, so I have a lot of money and I have a lot of health, and the zombies won't run at me. This is just for the tutorial. You guys obviously won't have this good of luck with zombies and money, but you're gonna come through here. You're gonna immediately spawn into the Egypt part of the map, in the Ra Tower, if you will. This is the entrance to the Ra Tower. You're gonna have these sphinxes and stuff, like a little pond and just a bunch of hieroglyphics. And you can obviously tell that you're in like an Egyptian time. There's a wall by here for, I like to call it the Mauser, but it's the escargot. But it's the Mauser, automatic Mauser. And there's gonna be stairs leading up to another floor on your right. So we're gonna go ahead and go up these first. And then if you come up here, you're gonna see a mystery box location as soon as you come through, as well as a shotgun wall by. Now, there's gonna be shield parts in this room. It's going to be just one shield part. It's going to be either here, here, and I believe somewhere over here. But it's going to be somewhere in this room. You guys are going to go ahead and figure out where it is just by going around this room. But again, let's come through like we just came through. And you see the shotgun. You turn to your right, you're going to see the gong that you're going to activate to summon the champion. This is how you unlock Pack-a-Punch. You guys will see a common thing. You unlock 4 gongs and just hit them, summon the champion, kill the champion, you'll receive a drop. But again, we're not going to do that just for the sake of the tutorial. We're just going to keep it right there. So anyway, you're coming out again, you see the gong, turn to your left, and you immediately see the statue of Ra, which in my game is for stamina. I like to keep stamina with Ra just because it is a way I can get around the map quicker. You're going to see a lot of different Egyptian things along this side. Again, it's an easy way to remember where you are based upon which mythology you're in. But this is the altar room, and you guys can obviously tell that this is for Egyptian mythology. So anyway, from the right of the Ra statue, you're going to see a bridge that you're going to go ahead and open up, and it's going to lead to another area. This is the route that I like to take, guys. This isn't a route you have to take, but this is the one I prefer to take. It just seems a lot more just beneficial. There's going to be a trap here that you guys can activate right here. It's going to send these spikes down, and it's going to go ahead and kill these zombies. But again, we're not going to activate it just for the sake of the tutorial. You're going to come through here, and this is the Celtic, yes, the Celtic lore room. This is going to be for Danu, and I have Quick Revive for Danu. But you can obviously change these to whichever one you like. You're going to have the Danu statue on your left as soon as you walk in, and you're going to have the Tree of Life right in front of you. You come to your right, and there's going to be another shotgun on the wall. This one is actually very effective. I like using that. And then right in front of that, it's going to be another mystery box location, and in front of that, the gong to summon the champion for Danu. You guys can obviously see that there's not going to be another bridge this way, so there's only one way you guys can go. Rip zombie. So you're going to go ahead and go downstairs. You're going to see just these lights and stuff. It's a very mystical Celtic feeling. The Tree of Life again is right here. So that's why you always know you're in the Danu Tower. All of the areas that we're going to be exploring today are going to be designated toward a certain mythical god. So just keep that in mind. So we come down here, you're going to see a door that will lead back into the starting room, which is one of the doors that we previously looked at while looking at the starting room. Again, you'll see the starting room weapon right here. I call it the Winchester, but this is just a good way to recognize where you are. There's two starting weapons in this room, of course. But anyway, we're going to come through here and just continue where we were. And right next to the door, you're going to see a RK7. It's just basically the RK5. And it's a good wall weapon to have if you guys want to just go ahead and go about the map and just traversing all of its, you know, difficulties. But anyway, across from the RK7, you're going to see a corridor, which we're going to go down to continue our little ultimate guide. You're going to keep going down until you can't, basically. You run into the bottom of the Tree of Life. It's going to split into two parts. And we're just going to stay to the right of the wall. That way we can navigate this entire area. So again, you're going to see another mystery box location here. And you keep going straight. On your left, you're going to see an SMG wall buy. This is for the SOG 9mm. It's a good SMG if you guys don't want to buy the RK7. It's a good alternative, in my opinion. And there's basically it for this room. It just looks very nice. It reminds me of a lot of Zetsubou no Shima. There's a scepter here for Celtic mythology. Again, like runes and whatnot. But we're going to keep going this way. You're going to find a wall. A door that you have to open to continue down this corridor. Now, you're caught in two different ways you can go. What I like to do is I like to always go right. You notice it in just the way I play. Yeah, right is the right way. So we're going to go right, and we'll end up over there again. But again, we have the Mazu wall by right there. We're going to continue down the right way. I had a small voice crack. We're going to ignore that. You can't actually open this, so this is the only way you can go. Let's go ahead and open this door. We're going to continue down this hallway. And it looks like you're in a kind of catacombic area of the map now. So we're going to go very slow here. There is a trap here you can activate, of course. You're going to keep going straight. And you have the GKS wall by. Go towards your right. And it's just like a very scenic kind of catacombic area again. I'm just going to get rid of these zombies a little bit. My gun isn't exactly the best, but you know. So there's not much here. Not much you can do here, of course. But you have the GKS wall by that's going to be directly in front of you. And then if we go back to the way we came into the catacombic area, you turn to your left and you're going to go up these stairs. And this is actually where you make a pack-a-punch. Now, you're going to have usually a like a stairway here. And this is pack-a-punch. This is the back end of pack-a-punch because if you come over here to the front, you're going to have these spires, which are going to actually put the champion's blood, which is actually the items that drop when you hit the gongs for the specific gods. So they're going to have their champions come out, which are usually these different gladiators, and you kill them, they drop items, you bring them down here. There's only four that you need, there's four gods, it makes sense, you activate pack-a-punch. So we're going to go back up the way we came, and so we're down here, and you're going to keep going, you obviously see pack-a-punch, we're going to keep going back up the way we came. We're going to go back up the way we came, because this is the central hub of the map, I like to think, so we're going to go back the way we came. And you see the GKS wall by, you see how we entered the catacombs from the Danu temple. So we're going to keep going straight. And you're going to run into more of like a Templar area. This is where like the Roman kind of Greek thing is. You have a mystery box location here. And you're going to see, like, I like to call this the premise room just because there's four of them. But that's obviously not very accurate to storyline. So we're just going to just disregard that. You're going to go straight. You're going to see a KN wall by a very good gun that you absolutely would love to have. And obviously there's only one way you can go. So we're going to go continue down this way. Kill that zombie. And you're going to have this doorway that leads up to the Odin and Zeus temple. So this is going to be the last two gods that you're going to represent. So we're going to go ahead and go up this way. It's going to be a door that you can buy. Again, this is my route. If you guys don't like this route, you don't have to use it, but this is the one I prefer. So you're in this like Greek kind of very marble-esque room, which is very clean and just very nice. I say that as there's a blood pool, but you guys know what I mean. So this mystery box location here, you're going to have the blood pool, obviously directly in the center. You're going to go around that because that shit's weird. You know, continue going up the stairs. You see all these marble statues, these urns and stuff. It's very obviously Greek. You keep going upstairs, and you're going to find a ICR wall by right there on the right. Very good gun as well. And again, we're in the marble kind of, area that you that you obviously would know would be Greek. And then this obviously leads back to spawn. Most of these doors that you're going to see obviously lead to the spawn. I'm going to come through here just to show you guys. This is spawn. You open these doors so you can always head back in case you want to remember where a gun is. You're like, oh, so Zeus has the ICR, and there you go. So we're going to come back through where spawn was, and we're going to go upstairs again. And obviously, there's going to be a trap here, but you're going to have to actually actually open up and get a couple more parts for that. But we're going to come up here, and you're in the Zeus, obviously, temple. And so you have the gong for the Zeus's champion on your right. You're going to keep going. You're going to have the Titan wall by, which is a really good LMG. It's very overpriced, in my opinion. But they could obviously change that. Again, there's the trap thing that here that needs additional parts. You can find a mystery box location right in front of you. And then following your left, you're going to find the Zeus altar. The Zeus altar is very direct and very like prominent. You obviously know, like, oh, it's the Zeus altar. To the right of the Zeus altar is a window. Obviously, nothing here. You're going to keep going straight from the Zeus altar and go right. And there's going to be a bridge. And as you know from before, when we opened up the Ra temple, we're going to go just cross these stairs. And now we're in the Odin temple. Now, the Odin temple is very, very wooden, very runic, almost like the new. But the Odin temple is for Norse mythology, obviously. So you're going to see a lot of like arcs and stuff like that, boats and stuff. But anyway, as you come straight out of the doorway, on your left is the Odin altar. On your right, it's going to be the Augur wall by. I really like this weapon. If I can't find a sniper, I always go for that. And then directly to your front is the mystery box location. And to the left of that is the gong for Odin's champion. And you guys can basically get what you need to do. You summon the champion, kill the champion, and you go put all four heads into the actual pack-a-punch. Now, just give me 1 second, guys. This is a live commentary. I wanted this to be just as fresh as possible so you guys understood what I was talking about. So we're going to go ahead and just get rid of these guys. Just cause less traffic. Anyway, again, you have the boat directly across this gong that you're going to hit so you can summon the champion, kill the champion, gain the drop, and be able to pack punch. So another corridor that leads downstairs, obviously you guys will know where it leads. It's going to lead to a vapor wall bite, and that's actually a very good gun as well. Straightforward from the vapor wall bite is back to spawn, a very common pattern with these doors and with these rooms and whatnot. So we're going to go from the spawn entrance all the way forward, and you're going to see the only way you can possibly go is a corridor downstairs. Now, this isn't a guide to show all the shield parts and stuff. This is more of a map location, so you get to understand how the map works. So if I don't get all the shield part locations, I apologize. This is just, I'm just saying how's it going. I apologize, guys. But I'm going to keep going down from the only way you can possibly go from the Odin altar, and you're in the Odin Tower Cauldron. So the cauldron actually has wood that you are obviously going to have to put into there for the Easter egg or some upgrade. Get rid of the zombie. And so let's just act right here, and to your left, you're going to see a mystery box location. Keep going from that location, and you're going to find a door that you have to open directly ahead. Nothing is in this room, particularly, such as like wall buys or anything like that. So you're going to go ahead and open this door, come down again, and you're right back to where you started. If you guys remember, we actually went up from this area, from the catacombs into the Zeus area, so we're right back to where we started in the middle of our journey. So now I'm going to come through here just to show you guys again that this is like the mid between Zeus. There's the Zeus statues. So we can go ahead and head towards the right after exiting the Odin temple, and you're going to have the Maddox on the wall, which is a very good gun to have, and you're going to follow through with this wall. You're going to have one entrance to go through. It's going to lead to another trap that you can use, and then you're going to come through here and have a trap directly in front of you as well. You're going to have two ways you can go. So directly in front of you, you're going to have a wall by for the Spitfire, and on your right, you're going to have a building table. So we're going to go ahead and go to the right just for sake of the guide, and you're going to have these building tables that obviously you'd be able to build on whichever you want. There's just nothing really here on the right side. You're going to have the middle again with the Spitfire that you can reach out and grab, so we're going to go back down here and show through here, and there's a mystery box location right here on the left. This will also lead directly to the Danu Tower. So it's the Danu Tower as well as the Ra Tower. So everything is in a circle, If you guys remember, I said that Pack Punch was directly in the middle, so we're going to go back just real fast in case I confuse you guys. And so we have the middle. Excuse me. We have the middle, which we had the table for the building and whatnot. And directly in front of us is the way to the raw tower. So we're going to go ahead and go across here just to show you guys once more. On your left is a mystery box location. Keep going straight and just follow the corridor. You're going to have a, what is this, MX9 wall by on your left. Keep going through this corridor and you're in the raw temple once again, directly in center with Pack-a-Punch. And you have the Dinu temple. Everything is connected. We're going to go ahead and open this door. Just so you guys know, there's the Bowie knife right as you get out of here, a mystery box location, and a sarcophagus that leads up into the raw temple. But we'll go through that here in a second. Let's continue down our way to Pack-a-Punch, just as you see that everything is circular. So we come through here, and this is how you enter. Workbench again on your right. Let's go left this time. You go up the stairs, and again, here's Pack-a-Punch, Swordfish wall by right in front of you. Continue down these steps, and boom, you're at the front of Pack-a-Punch. Everything is connected. Pack-a-Punch is the central hub of the entire map. You have the different doors, which lead to different gods and whatnot, obviously. So I believe this is how it was meant to be, to where the Pack-a-Punch was directly in middle, so you absolutely know which way you need to go. So we're just going to skedaddle out of here because I'm not trying to, you know, die and whatnot. So let's see where this leads us real fast. So we're back in the catacombic area. We're gonna go back towards the other side, actually, that way you guys don't lose sense of direction. Take elixir real fast, guys. Boom, 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 boom. Boom, skaboom. All right, again, here's the swordfish wall by. You're gonna come through here, and we're gonna continue down towards the raw temple. Again, mystery box on your left. Follow this corridor, the M9X, follow this corridor, and you have the Temple of Ra right here. You open this door, the Bowie knife is directly here. Go ahead and grab it so you guys see. It looks sick. Gonna follow through this esophagus. I did it again, sarcophagus. You have a mystery box location here. You have these guys that will try and kill you. So you go ahead, head up these stairs again. You're gonna obviously see that the Egyptian layout is back, and you are back in the Temple of Ra, of which you started with in the very beginning when you first turned in. And you have the pool, the sphinxes, and the Mauser wall by. So yeah, guys, that is the full guide that I can provide at this moment for the map 9. If you guys did enjoy, if you could drop a like, that'd be greatly appreciated. If you guys want me to do more videos like this, go ahead and leave a comment down below. Like I said, this is where a spawn is. You guys spawn in, obviously. You'll obviously spawn in right here, and then turn to your right. And this is my route that I like to take again. So if you guys don't like that, I mean, you can always make up your own route, but this was just to get you guys understood to what each and every one of these like little doorways leads to. So this is the Tower of Ra, just to clarify. And this is the Danu Tower. And then you're going to continue over this way. And this should be the Tower of Zeus because of the Greek statues. And then lastly, this is the Tower of Odin. Continue down this way. And it's just a Viking wooden vibe. And again, you have the starting room, and you're right back to where you spawned in. Again, guys, thank you so much for watching. Drop a like in the video, subscribe if you're new, and if you guys want to watch some Call of Duty Black Ops 4 streams, go ahead and follow me over on Twitch. I'll see you guys later. Peace out.